In part 5 of our lesson on trigonometric equations, you will learn how to solve for all possible radian solutions. In this example, we have to solve for all radian solutions the equation 2 sine squared of x plus 7 is equal to 8 minus sine of x. The first order of business will be to gather up all the terms on the left-hand side. So we get 2 sine squared of x plus sine of x. And then we have to do 7 minus 8. So we get minus 1 equals 0. Next, we will FOIL factor. So we can get our parentheses going, equals 0, to get the 2 sine squared of x, we'll take 2 sine of x times sine of x. We know to get 1, we're going to put a 1 and a 1. Because it's negative 1, we know that one of them will be a plus and one will be a minus. And that's controlled by the middle term having to be plus 1 sine of x. So we will make the 2 sine of x positive and the 1 sine of x negative. Applying the zero product property, we get 2 sine of x minus 1 has to equal 0, or sine of x plus 1 has to equal 0. Let's work on this equation first. We see that we'll need to add 1 to both sides. So now we have 2 sine of x is equal to 1. Dividing by 2, we get sine of x is equal to 1/2. Now we're ready to draw a picture where sine of x has to be positive. When that happens, we know that we have to be in quadrants 1 and 2. Looking at our special angle chart, we go to the sine row, look for the value of 1/2, and we see that theta r is going to be pi over 6. Putting theta r in quadrant 1, we see this will be pi over 6. Putting theta r in quadrant 2, we have to do pi minus pi over 6, and we get 5 pi over 6. In this problem, we are being asked to find all the radian solutions. So what happens is, when we say that x can be pi over 6, that's not the only angle there. X could be all the angles that are coterminal with pi over 6, because if the angle kept rotating around again, or if it rotated around twice, or if it rotated around 3 times, or if it rotated in the negative direction, you can see there will be infinitely many angles that are coterminal with pi over 6. The rotation between those angles is a multiple of 2 pi. If it were to go around one more time, that would be adding 2 pi. If it went around 2 more times, that would be adding 4 pi. If it went around 3 more times, that would be adding 6 pi. So for all the radian solutions, We say that x could be pi over 6 plus 2n pi. It's also true here at 5 pi over 6 that the same thing will happen. Every angle that is coterminal with 5 pi over 6 will also be a solution to the equation. So it's also true that x is 5 pi over 6 plus 2n pi. And those two solutions come from this first part of the equation. Over here, we have the sine of x plus 1 is 0, so we will subtract 1 from both sides and get that the sine of x has to equal negative 1. We can draw that picture, and we know that that happens here at 3 pi over 2. But just like we discussed before, it will happen for every angle that is coterminal with 3 pi over 2. So once it rotates all the way around again, that's where we're adding in the 2n pi. Because remember, all the way around is 2 pi, around twice is 4 pi, 6 pi, 8 pi. That's why we say 2n pi. So from this second equation, we get that x is 3 pi over 2 plus 2n pi. So these would be all the solutions to our original equation. In this example, we have to solve for all radian solutions, and we are given the equation secant squared of x is equal to 6 minus secant of x, and where needed, we have to round to the nearest hundredth of a radian measure angle. The secant squared is positive on the left-hand side here, so we'll bring these two terms over from the right-hand side to the left-hand side, and we get secant squared of x plus secant of x minus 6 will equal 0. We can factor this one, so we'll get our parentheses in there. Set it equal to 0. To get secant squared, we need secant x times secant x. To get 6, we could either do 1 and 6 or 2 and 3. Since our middle term has to be a positive 1, then it makes sense for us to use 2 times 3. Now we need a positive 1, so then we will have the 3 secant of x be positive, and the 2 secant of x will be negative. Applying the zero product property, we get secant of x minus 2 has to equal 0, or secant of x plus 3 has to equal 0. Let's take this first equation. We would add 2 to both sides, and now we have secant of x is equal to 2. We can trade this in by using the reciprocal identity and get cosine of x is equal to 1/2. We know that if cosine of x is positive, then that means we will have to be in quadrant 1 or quadrant 4. Using our special angle chart, we go in the cosine row to the value of 1/2, and we see that we are going to get that our reference angle is equal to pi over 3, putting the reference angle in quadrant 1, we get pi over 3. Putting the reference angle in quadrant 4, we know we have to do 2 pi minus pi over 3, which many of you are getting comfortable doing that in your head, and I want you to go ahead and do that in your head if you feel comfortable. If not, write this out as 6 pi over 3 minus pi over 3, which is 5 pi over 3. So we come up here and put 5 pi over 3. So we know from the first equation, our solutions are going to be that x is equal to pi over 3 plus, going all the way around any number of times in the forward direction or the backward direction, we have to add 2n pi, or x is 5 pi over 3 plus 2n pi. Let's take a look at this second equation. We would subtract 3 from both sides. So now we have secant of x is equal to negative 3. Using the reciprocal identity here, we will say that cosine of x is negative 1/3. If cosine of x is negative, we know that means we have to be in quadrant 2 or quadrant 3. One-third is not one of the values on our special angle chart, so we know that means we are going to need to use our calculator to find the cosine inverse of negative 1/3. For this problem, we are going to need our calculator to be in radian mode, so you hit the DRG button, put the cursor to the right so that it's under radians, and hit enter. And now we will do the cosine inverse, so we have to hit second, cosine inverse, negative 1 divided by 3, hit the enter, and rounding to the nearest hundredths place, we see that we are going to get 1.91. Now, as we go around our picture here, we know that this is 0. At pi over 2, we know that would be 1.57. Here at pi, we know is 3.14. Down here at 3 pi over 2 is 4.71. So this 1.91 that we got is our quadrant 2 angle. But we do need to find our reference angle, which will be right here. To get theta r, we will subtract 3.14 minus 1.91. And if we enter that on our calculators, we get 1.23 is our reference angle. Now we have to take this reference angle and get it into quadrant 3. Our quadrant 3 angle then, we will start at pi, which we're going to use 3.14, and we have to add to that the reference angle, which we found to be 1.23. So if we grab our calculators and do 3.14 plus 1.23, we get 4.37. We can put that in our picture here. So then from the second equation, we get x is equal to 1.91. So that's this quadrant 2 angle, and then all the coterminal angles going all the way around, so add 2n pi. Or x is equal to the quadrant 3 angle here, which is 4.37, plus all of its coterminal angles, 2n pi. So those are the two solutions for this half. So then that means the solutions to the original equation, there are these four answers.